don't care if nobody says. I love Chris Sale's music.
I can fall in love like that. It's supposed to be me. I can't get it down like that. I still love enough to love you.
Hey.
Oh wow, this is a shoebox now. Double stop playing alimony checks.
Wait, I'm sorry, hold on, first of all.
One little stove and one painting on the wall. Where the bedrooms at?
Alright, we're not gonna do this, Trace. Don't hate them, but I feel like they really need to find something better to do. If they do so happen to respond to this, just know you're not getting a response back because I have black kids to uplift on this channel. This is just for entertainment purposes. This is just for fun. Mademoiselle, and this is my channel, and I got Trace TV.
Hi, guys!
You do not stop doing that shit. Today, we are going to be doing the most highly requested video we've had in months, okay? Sorry we haven't done it sooner, but this is our first time meeting up in months, okay? And that is the reacting to your favorite YouTubers. The first one.
Basically, y'all tell us a whole bunch of YouTubers that y'all like to react to, like what's your thoughts on so-and-so,
yeah.
And there's over like 30 names on our list, so we're gonna react to a whole bunch of them.
Right, so you guys, I asked you guys on Instagram if you want me to react to, bro, y'all sent over 200, I think it's at 300 now, fucking requests. I went through some of them, I picked 11. One's a family channel, 5 boys, 5 girls. I tried to mix it up a little bit, if it ain't mixed enough for you, oh well, wait a couple months for the next one. Y'all sent me so many people that I already fuck with, like Loho, Chama, Keisha, who else they sent me that I'm like, bruh, like you don't see how you associate with these people, like we follow each other on the gram, like what's up with y'all? Y'all sent me like, hey Paris, I've been watching her since I was like, before I even had a channel, like come on now.
That's right.
Could y'all send more diverse people? A lot of y'all did a good job, because I could say 95% of the people I had on my list, I ain't never heard of, I ain't never seen.
Yeah, it's literally just black people,
yeah.
Makeup bitches or natural
hair. Yeah, y'all sent some boring ass bitches. I was like, I'm not about to react to no mukbangers or natural hair YouTubers. We not reacting to that. So we picked a good
send
range.
Some crackers like Jeffree Star and Shane.
We already know them.
Oh, yeah, we do.
And why you gotta call them crackers?
Because they all have racist scandals.
You're right.
Even though they all apologize and we're very forgiving people. Let me just make a disclaimer. If you're mentioned in this video, react to your shit. Anyone at all that gets mentioned in this video, it's no offense, it's our opinion, okay? It's
our opinion.
We don't know y'all personally, we don't have an issue. If you ever see us in person, it's not that serious. It's our opinion, okay?
It is what it is. If you're mad, you're mad. We don't care. We said what we said. You see my shirt? You want my merch? I said what I said. I meant what I said, and I'll say it again. Go get it down in the description box, pinned comment down below. That's the motto for this video, okay?
It is what it is. And if you mad, then get you a cape and be super mad.
Where did you get that from?
I don't know where I got that from.
I didn't like that. Anyways, we're going to start off this video now. The first person on the list, I've heard of him, and I think this is the only person we actually both heard of. I haven't watched him in a while, like a good while, like almost a year. I haven't watched him in a good minute.
Because he's boring as fuck.
I don't know what he makes now. I think he's really cute, but our first victim is Smooth Geo. I think he's adorable, and I fell in love with his little interviews and shit, but the reason I stopped watching was because I heard he made a light skin versus dark skin type of situation video. We all know how I feel about those public interviews.
Those videos are so fucking corny. Like,
I hate it.
He's the only race that do that.
Yeah, but I mean, I understand that's like his niche, not giving him a pass, but ever since he made that video, I just don't watch him anymore because it's like, I'm not supporting that type of fuck shit, but we gonna pick son. I haven't watched him in a year or two, so we'll see what he doing nowadays. Hopefully, it's something niggas can watch. Troyce, please try not to shut off the fucking camera like last time.
Oh no, I won't. This time I can't.
Yeah, this time he can't. He can't do nothing because the thing is like over here. All right, so first of all, ooh, we got a lot of options here. So what we want to watch? Who Knows Their Girlfriend Better featuring DeShay Frost. The Hotel Invasion featuring DeShay Frost. Who is DeShay Frost?
DeShay Frost is basically another nigga who's derived from DDG. DDG carbon copy.
The Truth About Me and Diamond Flawless. Oh god, he's making the DDG content now?
DDG is their father. It's like, bitch, you can't.
Yo, shut the fuck up.
These YouTubers are
so. Yo, why you gotta do that?
Like, y'all all post the same shit. I think she likes me. If it's not that, y'all are either doing some corny ass clickbait, some weak ass prank.
Who is Diamond Flawless? She look cute in the thumbnails.
Some high school student who takes ass pics on Instagram. No, I'm kidding. She graduated high school a couple months ago.
I don't know. What do you think?
Okay. That one.
Trace, be respectful, okay?
And give constructive criticism.
Yes, constructive. If you click this, you will be blessed. Why the fuck of all videos you chose this? I'm scared. Alright. I like this intro. This is cute. It looks like a music video, like a hood music video.
This is corny ass intro.
Hey, he's so adorable! I don't know why he's so adorable.
He has like a baby face.
Yes.
Million subscribers this year.
Imagine being this successful at 18.
I never lied to you about my age, you know, you're probably like 23, I would say.
We know someone who's lying about their age on YouTube.
Burger Queen.
You know, we can't do it, you know what I'm saying? But nah, look,
that's why you're going to the place, we're not going to say the name.
Look, if you live in Florida, I need all my supporters.
You live in Florida?
He lives in Orlando.
Bro, these are DDG songs, I'm sorry. They all do the same shit. First of all, this reminds me of old DDG.
Yeah.
This is what DDG used to do in his dorm room. First of all, alright, I think that's enough. I'm tired of this shit already. I don't really care about his life because I'm not subscribing again. I think he's adorable though.
Wait, what did he say?
What
did he say about his life? What was the update? Because I wasn't listening.
His birthday is March something. He's graduating and he's gonna start a vlog channel. And this will go to the video that we not watching.
A vlog channel? Where did that come from?
They all do that! Like you said, at DDG's I honestly thought about starting a backup channel, but I'm not vlogging. Y'all keep asking me to vlog, I'm not doing that shit. I don't do nothing. All I do is go to the gym and come back home, bro.
YouTubers and their 5 channels.
Yo, deadass. Why? If you're a YouTuber, please comment down below. Why the fuck you got all these damn channels? The constructive criticism for Gio.
Constructive criticism for Gio that he needs to stop being so fucking boring. And it needs to get to the point.
Dad, I don't think he was boring.
It bored the hell out of me. I'm like, I think that this is for, I feel like I don't write vlogs like this. Like, hey, welcome back to another, I find that so corny. I click off, bitch, swipe down, swipe out. I end the video when people do that.
You ain't had to do all of that.
No, for real. Like, I'm bored. I hate when people do that.
What's up, y'all? Welcome back to another video.
Bitch, Okay, 8 seconds of you doing, okay,
bye. Okay, so you coming for me? Because my intro be so long. I'll be like, what up?
Intros. Double tap. Okay, thank you.
So you're the one fucking up my ad revenue?
I just try to, or sometimes I just mute.
Okay, since we telling the truth here, I skip through your stupid ass thumbnails where you be doing that shit for like 2 minutes. Comment down below if you think that shit annoying as fuck. Since we telling the truth.
Oh yeah.
Asshole. Anyhow, our next one is a female and her name is Grace. If I mess up your name, Alijour, I don't know.
How many subscribers does she have?
149K. Smoojio had the million something, if y'all didn't know. 149K. I'm not sure what her niche is. It says chit chat, advice, vlogs, love life. Not sure what to click on. It says why your credit score is zero. That was her latest video. Then there's part one, answering your Twitter DMs. Always remember your bomb as fuck. I guess this is a motivational video. Giveaway winners. 5 things I will not accept from men this summer. Ooh, I kind of like that one. When you slim, pretty little thing, try on, you're definitely not doing that. Story time, stupid things I purchased with my loan. Okay, so I guess she's trying to do like the whole advice situation. Drunk mukbang uncut. Okay, I don't know what to say, bruh. African mall, yay or nay. Those are her latest videos, but she's not very active. 1 week, 3 weeks, 1 month, 1 month, 2 months. Yeah, she's not very active. I don't know what to click on.
That's a red flag.
It is a red flag, but I mean, that's a business. I feel like I want to watch 5 things I will not accept from men this summer. 22 minutes. Oh God, it's also a sponsor, so get ready for that.
Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. How is everybody?
Where's she from? UK?
Hello,
Beyonce here. I like it.
Nigeria.
The only thing
is this. Is she Nigerian? Oh. So look, the Nepali. The Nepali is.
I like her.
The fact that it can show. So you gotta be careful with it because if you just do. The press will just do.
Girl, that was me today with that business too.
Upset. Okay, I'm gonna spirit to look back at this video and see my breast again because I'm in your spirit. This video is sponsored by Sky. I love you so much. Thank you. Patronizing me. I thank you for
she's, it's the accent. I'm sold.
I like her accent.
Love it.
Yeah, so one is being made at the moment, and I've decided that I'm going to
tear off me.
Just make sure that you make sure that you're first in line. This is a 3 giveaway, beautiful
okay.
For the summer.
Girl, I like you, so we skip into this sponsor. Sorry.
Go down that list and check if you want to fucking subscribe to me. If you're not subscribed, you're not getting any wig. Okay? Please pay attention.
She's still like 2 minutes.
Because if you miss it, I don't want to hear any.
Okay, that's why you had to do that. That's mad.
And the alarm just went off in my head. Okay, wait, you're down here, yeah, but this is the girl section. Must be a girl that you're here with. But I thought, just see. Let me just walk around and see what it is. I knew he was going to approach me anyway. So obviously, beautiful thing. I already knew in my spirit. He didn't look at me like, oh, I know her from social. He looked at me like, oh, you're looking kind of kinky still. So I thought, let me just start going downstairs and start, you know, analyzing downstairs, analyzing nothing. By the way,
she doesn't look ugly.
I just was looking, oh, wow. Okay, I see him still by the door, yeah, and he's like on the phone or something. And I'm thinking, oh, please, God, like, you better say hello to me.
No, she reminds me.
He just comes up to me, he's like, you're right.
Trish, you're going to hell in a handbasket, first of all.
It's just the hair.
I was gonna fucking say, RF Fabulous, because of the accent and then the way she's telling her story.
The Brent Cox is a stunning woman.
Yeah, but like, you mad far-fetched. Like, I'm... oh my God.
Much later.
Damn, I don't have my watch. Alright.
Bored as fuck.
Yeah, I'm getting bored.
But
she's pretty.
Very pretty.
That's really what it is.
She's nice to look at, but okay.
Okay, next one. Eric the Electric. Now, I looked this up earlier as I was compiling my list and I was disgusted. I'm gonna tell you this right off the bat. What the fuck is this shit? I'm sorry. What is this? First of all, so apparently he makes eating videos, doing calorie challenges. So 10,000 calories in a day challenges.
You gonna die from high cholesterol.
Like, high cholesterol.
High blood pressure.
Fuck. Like,
I don't know why people don't stay in shit.
Why do people do this type of shit? First of all, Troy, you be in trash. That's but this is worse than anything I've ever seen. To actually sit there and like buy this much food. Well, these taxes must be lit. That's a lot of write-offs, bruh. A lot of write-offs. But I guess I'm gonna pick his latest video. Oh wow, 6 hours ago. I let my girlfriend pick my 10,000 calorie challenge. Why are you eating 10,000 calories? Where did this, I don't understand why that's, why is this, who made this up? I'm gonna click on his latest video. Fuck it. I'm not even about to look at the other stuff.
Get ready, crap fans, cause crap
fans. Oh my god, these ads, the ads! All right.
I like the intro.
I do too, that was really good. And it goes with his brand.
What is going on, everybody? Eric Gay Electric coming back to you guys
again. And his grandma.
With another video. Here's the thing, everybody. The infamous 10,000 calorie challenge made its way around the internet a couple years ago. And in 2015, I took it upon myself to try the 10,000 calorie challenge. Well, it actually turned into the 15,000 calorie challenge because I kind of went over the 10,000 calorie challenge. And then I tried the 25,000 calorie challenge. And then the 30,000 calorie challenge. And then it pretty much just ended up into the a lot more than 10,000 calories.
This
so I asked myself, you know, what would it be like if I did a 10,000 calorie challenge? And then I realized it'd actually be a lot more fun if my girlfriend chose my 10,000 calorie challenge. My girlfriend, Christy, absolutely loves food. She loves a lot of the foods that I love. She also loves a lot of the foods that I don't love. So for this video, I'm going to put the fate of this challenge into Christy's hands, and I'm going to eat all the foods that she would eat if she were going to do a 10,000 calorie challenge. So that's just it, everybody. Electric Empire. As usual, I'm very hungry.
I want to know how old he is. Girlfriend, why he ain't got a wife?
Yeah.
Let's do this.
Hmm.
I wonder what you were doing all night. I was getting something. I was trying to make an entrance. All right, guys. So, Christy, hello. In case you didn't know, this is my girlfriend, Christy Diggs. Hopefully you guys have a great day, but let's get straight to it, all right? The title of this video is, My Girlfriend is Going to Choose My 10,000 Calorie
Challenge. Oh my god, where's the food, bitch? They in the grocery store? Now they walked into the car.
This nigga stretched the fuck out of this shit.
Oh my god, right. Now we finally, now we get some food. We took you 30 damn years.
That, my friends, is a Hawaiian pizza. If you guys have been around, it was anything big, but
oh my god, an ad, bitch, really? You gotta watch an ad before you actually eat? Okay, turn this shit off.
Stop, I wanna see.
I'm gonna give it a small bite. Very, very small. Very, very, very small. Let's do this, people. Can I actually
say,
it's better than I thought it was.
There's no way he's about to go after me.
Alright, everybody. Out there right now, you guys better comment down below what your favorite pizza topping is. For me, I always go with classic pepperoni. It's actually really good because I'm stoked to take on the world's biggest slice of pizza when we are going to be in New York next month. We're going to be at the Pizza Barn and they serve giant pizza slices there. It's going
to
be
epic. Oh, looks like that's where I need to visit.
Did I see
you can't eat pizza for next month.
Commission it.
I don't believe he's got to eat all of this food. That's already, oh my god, that's my calorie count.
Yeah, right. I want to see raw footage of this nigga eating this shit. How long?
Well, it's sped up.
It's sped up, but it's also chopped up.
All right, well, all of our pieces down, babe. I think I can give pineapple on my pizza.
I want to hear the passion. You know, some of these food is fries.
A lot of fries.
Now, what should we do next? Oreos now? Now, we gotta get into the double stuffed Oreos next.
Double stuffed Oreo?
Double
stuff. I can't even have two of those shits, bro. Them shits is too much.
Oh my god. Oh my god, I miss being double stuffed Oreo.
Right. Yeah, I haven't had Oreo in a while. That Oreo flavored shit, but Oreo.
Mmm. Alright, guys,
well,
that's it.
I want to know how edited this is.
Personally, I think anything above 5 seconds.
Is that coffee?
Get above 10 seconds. No. That's definitely sub-up.
All right. Let me just say his marketing is super. This marketing is really good.
The editing is good.
The editing is good. The questions in between the video is good because it keeps you watching. And the fact that he's allegedly eating all of this shit.
Okay, I'll give him that. He made good content.
He's very good at that.
But you're allegedly eating food.
Alright,
Over me, I'm raw footage of me eating. But this nigga,
this is unhealthy. I can't. Oh my goodness. What happens at the end of these? Like, what do you do at the end? Like, what is your, let me see. What the fuck is it? Oh my God, cereal, ooh, child. Donuts, fucking ad. I just wanna know, like.
Why do people get all the ads?
Girl. How do you sit there and eat this much food? Do you starve yourself for a week?
He stuffing that shit under his bed. Like, I'm telling you, he is not eating all this shit.
Yeah.
He's laughing all the way to the bank. People are actually buying this shit. He's like, you know you're gonna eat that shit.
Maybe he is. Comment down below. Do y'all really think he's eating all of this or no? And then the music is just making it so like
alive and dramatic.
Great marketing.
How about this? I'll believe he's eating all this shit if he weighs himself before and after.
Well, you're not gonna gain weight immediately. You have to gain weight like maybe a couple days.
No, you probably gained at least 2 or 3 pounds within hours.
Yeah, that is actually a lot of food.
So long to weigh himself hours.
Right, 10,000 calories, you're right. I'm not gonna subscribe, but good marketing.
You make decent content.
Very decent.
So I'll give you that. So on a scale from 1 to 10, I'll rate his channel a 7.
I give him, yeah, I was about to say that. I give him a 7. That was actually good. Okay, next we're going with a girl. Now, this one, I've never heard of most of these people. The only person I heard of was, Smooth Gio. Next one is Deja Lene. Never heard of her. I don't know if you heard of her. Well,
I don't know a lot of these damn people. I don't watch nobody on YouTube.
Right, I only watch my friends. If you got my number, I watch your videos. After that, I rarely watch anybody else unless it's like tea videos. So from what I saw earlier, what I'm looking at now, she seems to be like a school advice. Looks like she used to do some type of skit situation back in the day. Her last video was a day ago, which was a get ready with me first day of school. I really don't care. I don't hear nothing about school. I just got a master's. I'm tired. I don't hear nothing about school anymore. But she does a lot of back to school stuff.
I graduated a long time ago. I do not care about
it. Taking down my 2-month-old braids. We could watch that.
I went to a school with a bitch who had her plastic for 9 months.
Don't do that. You all know what's wrong. Like, maybe she couldn't afford it.
She couldn't afford her own natural hair.
No.
She could have took them shits out, but they right. People used to call her 9 months.
Wait, you were out all in 9 months?
And this one girl called her 9 months because she had her leave the whole school year.
That's not funny. Maybe she got redone a couple times. Yeah,
no, it was just the same when they were falling out, and then she was putting a bandana on top to come out.
If you're watching this, I feel bad. I ain't say nothing about you, sis. That's all Troy's.
Oh my God. I wasn't making fun of her. I was just like, oh.
I'm gonna ignore you. We're gonna start the video.
I was just in the cut trying not to laugh.
Hi guys, welcome to another video, and
she's cute. Very cute.
I'm going to be taking down these stupid old braids. As you can tell, I already started.
Her braids still look pretty damn good.
I took down a couple in the back.
Oh, these are the new things that girls are wearing now. I forgot the cards. I mean, I love
thank you guys so much for 500k, like...
Shit, come back! That's what I'm talking about.
500k?
Yeah. She has over 500k, y'all.
And she's a black girl.
Dark skin. Yes, queen!
Let's get to the video. Okay, so I don't have the comb, I don't have anything. This is what some of the hair that I've already taken out looks like. Look how long these braids are. She's gonna
take out. Oh my God, we're really gonna see her watch a braid.
No, sis. Why did she cut it? Yeah, you're supposed to cut it up to your hairline.
She was thinking about it.
Unbraid them? Who else talked for that?
Girl, you wild. Cut some shit. What are you doing? What is she doing? What are you doing?
She got time. She has no life.
She dead ass not cutting them?
No commentary.
Right, I thought she was gonna talk with this.
I'm the only one, like, once I get done brushing my teeth, I spit so much because I hate hate the taste of toothpaste. Like, now I want to swallow that stuff. So I'm just sitting here like,
Is that right?
Oh, I think I'm going to update my braces.
She's so smooth,
I'm scared, y'all. My gums are like swollen. So I'm scared. I feel like I'm not gonna look, I don't look cute with them right now, but like, I feel like I'm just gonna look worse. Like, I'm gonna downgrade. But, you know, sister's scared, but it's whatever. They have to come off sooner or later.
I just need to understand why she didn't cut them. Like, this is driving me insane. She's still on the same fucking braid. And this shit is freaking fast, like it's fast forwarded.
Oh wow.
Hopefully I get them removed before then, because I don't want to go into school with braces. I need to start with a fresh
pair. She's so cute though. I think she's very pretty.
She's pretty.
And she's very relatable. I guess that's why she has 500,000 subscribers.
So much on my teeth. It really makes your teeth whiter.
I wonder what made her go viral.
If you were getting braces and don't know what color to get, I would get black.
Let's see what her most.
Yeah. I mean, she makes videos for young
like, doctors.
So like, alright, sis, we get it. You're taking your hair down, so we don't need to watch anymore. No, she did skits. White parents versus black parents. That's
I've seen that a long time.
Nah, no, I'm like, okay.
That's how she went viral.
Oh, wow. Well, good job, sis. 500K,
black girl now.
Subscribe, but I like you because you don't make any type of content that relate to me.
I like
but,
seeing black people.
Right. Especially like I know a lot of my subscribers could definitely relate to her. She's in high school, she's black, she's beautiful, and she's dark skinned. So if y'all want more dark skinned girls to watch on the tube,
what's her name?
That's it. Her name is Deja Lene. D-E-J-A-H Lene, L-A-N-A-Y. I like her. See, so far we haven't had to drag nobody, y'all. Completely.
You haven't had to drag nobody.
Shut up. The next one is Young Dawn, the sauce god. Now, I didn't know what the hell this was. I was like,
Young
what?
Dawn, the sauce god? Why do all these fucking hood YouTube niggas have rapper names?
Shut up, because they want rappers in the future. This is what they do. They create
they end up like DJ. They make YouTube videos and I like you pranks. And she wants to F you prank.
And then all of a sudden they come out with an I like you song, some I like you Instagram. Bitch, mm-hmm. And then they even end up making a fake relationship, and then they fake breakup.
And they think that's gonna get their right
word. And then all of a sudden, the Instagram bitch got a YouTube channel, and then she makes basic bitch content.
And then they end up being in a relationship channel, and then they make a couple channels, they do butt bangs, they do fake ass pranks, and then they break up, and then she got her own channel with thousands of subscribers. We've seen this over and over.
Over and over it. So when you see these type of channels, that's usually what it is. But I don't think that this was this what this is. Like, I looked this up earlier because I had to, you know, do a little bit of research before we reacted. And I clicked on one video and I was like, oh wow, so these are, remember, y'all know LaToya Forever? I know you know LaToya Forever.
Yeah, cartoon.
These are like, yeah, cartoon type of story time. So I was like, oh my god, I'm gonna enjoy this, so I don't even know which one to do. So we got Why My First Girlfriend Broke Up With Me. I really wanted to watch that. When She Asks If You Like Her Back, The Greatest School Fight Ever featuring Swoozy, Meet My New Dog Animated Story, My Fast Food Demon Animated Story. Wait, what?
One day, I was in a classroom and I just so happened to see her talking to this other dude.
Why faces like that? They just little as fuck.
Like, it means a lot of girls like, and I saw her give him.
Love this. Oh, bruh. 1.4 million subscribers, by the way.
Hold up.
He's a handsome young man.
Yes, he is.
I always felt like I was being forced to take classes.
I don't like the color of his hair, but he's cute in the face.
I love tacos, quesadillas, delicious.
Isn't that a quesadilla?
Not trying to learn Spanish.
Yeah.
I feel Spanish twice, my G. And that's the beautiful thing about Skillshare, man. You take the classes you want to take them when you want to take it at the pace you want to take
it. This is the first time I get you skip through
dozens of topics across all kinds of business.
I've heard of this company though.
Topics. Can I say topics again? When you sign up for the premium membership, you get unlimited access to all the classes. And the beautiful thing is,
he's cute.
It's only girl. Girl.
You gotta get out of the paid ad.
I know someone that likes you. So I was like, for real? Okay. who is it? I can't tell you. It's a secret. What? Why would you tell me?
Girl, you can't tell me
who it is. I just told you.
Young. I know someone who likes you. It's a secret. It's like, oh, fuck, you told me that. Hold on, pause. So, there's this ongoing stereotype that girls don't know how to keep a secret longer than 72 hours, which is a lot of the time is true. A lot of girls
I know how to keep a secret. I just don't know how to lie. I'm a bad liar. But I can keep a secret. But if the person comes and asks me, I'm sorry. I'm not gonna say anything, but I'm a bad liar, so. I don't know. I think this is cute.
I don't even know why she likes you. Oh my god. Jeez. Bye.
Damn. I'm asking for the niche, y'all, if y'all see any of that.
Amy. Instantly love my jeans. That's all it took me.
The cartoon him is too cute.
And the first one wasn't even like mandatory, to be honest. So fast forward to the next day, and I walk into school with my head on a swivel, my knee, looking out for my future wifey. But I didn't really know anything about Amy. I knew who she was, but I didn't know where to find her. We didn't have any classes together. We didn't hang out with the same people. So I was just hoping to meet her at lunch or something. But the whole day goes by, no Amy. So it's after school again, and I'm just standing there, more than likely, and then tap, 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 right on my shoulder. So I turn around, and there she is, Amy A. Oh, hey, Amy. Hey, so Karen told me that she told you that I liked you or something? Oh, Well, what? Oh my god, well, do you like me back? Oh, yeah. Okay,
has that ever happened to you?
So,
my first little relationship happened.
Right, cool. I didn't know stuff like this actually happened.
I gotta go to soccer practice now, so I'm gonna go, okay? But we'll hang out soon, okay? Alright, bye.
Yo, I can't. I like this. I'm subscribing. This is the first person I said I'm subscribing to, y'all.
Yeah, I do love this.
I am in a full blown relationship, my G.
I'm invested in this.
This was my first real girlfriend. That from like the fifth grade or whatever it was, that don't count. That was a facade. But broski, this girl right here, this girl had my heart. Okay. Now, I had no game as a jit. And the quickest
so
way
as a jit, he's from Miami. He's from Florida.
Especially when you have no game.
Jit? Okay, okay. So let me explain to y'all what jit is.
Because
so he said, I had no game as a jit. For those of you guys who are from Florida, jit basically means youngin' or little kid. So when someone says, oh, you a jit, that means you a youngin'.
I didn't know that. I've never heard that.
Yeah, term. It's a Florida. It's Miami lingo, but all of Florida has adopted it.
And if you don't have any game to curb the natural goofy tendencies that Lovell make guys do, like being jealous or clingy, you're bound to turn her off eventually. And those were the two things that would ultimately lead to Amy breaking.
I was actually teaching a lesson.
So first, the jealousy. So one day, Amy gives me a little class picture of her. I didn't ask for it, but she gave it to me. This was before smartphones, so this was like her version of sending me a selfie, I guess. I don't know, but you know, I thought it was like
a masturbate to it. I don't know why she gave me a picture.
Well, one day I was in a classroom and I just so happened to see her talking to this
man. They need to hire this man.
Was what we would call a gallus. Like, it means a lot.
An animation
life. And I saw her give him one of the little picture things instantly. I was heartbroken. I felt so...
Men are so extra.
I remember just looking through the window and thinking, I have to kill him. I think I would kill him now. But I don't know what that led to. But I know he was bothering me a lot.
This is very family friendly, sure. That
he came across, which would have undoubtedly turned her off. That was like day four, and the downhill only gets steeper. Cause on like day seven, the clinginess came through to finish it off. So it was after school, and she was at soccer practice. So I decided to go to like where the people hang out by the soccer field, and I shouldn't have been there. It was too much, because I was clearly there to watch her practice with the team. And that's just a bad game.
I don't see what's wrong with that.
It's clingy, as if
I think that's cute.
I had nothing else to do, which I didn't at the time, but you know, I could have been scouting this. For new
It's almost done. Yo, the fact that we sat through this, except for the ad, that's good. That's a good sign. Because I'm mad invested in this shit.
Like kicking balls into the goal, you know, and some extra practice ball is life type. And then one of the senior players on the girls' soccer team sees me. She sees me watching. And she knew Amy and I were, you know, a thing. So she sees me and calls me down to the field. You know, it's a
hell. It's not gonna work.
So I see this and I'm like, this is my chance. This is my chance to prove to Amy that I'm the best boyfriend that she could ever have. You know?
Yeah, they were dating. This is the story of how his first girlfriend dumped him.
Yeah, all just in the span of 2 days.
I'm walking down to the field.
I think we're only 6
I'm walking down, I choose to walk over the little ball bag that holds the soccer ball.
I think my partial wedding should last for like a month.
The ball bag, I can trip my G. I don't.
He needs some milk.
I trip in front of the entire like girls soccer team, and they're all laughing. And then Amy, like, she's embarrassed because I'm her boyfriend.
Dang.
She broke up with me after practice.
I'm sorry, that's horrible. She's shallow.
Hold up. Music too.
What did we just say about the music thing? What did we just say about the music thing? We were right. Oh, we didn't even know. What?
This is definitely a 10 out of 10.
Definitely subscribing. I have no bad things to say. That was mad entertaining. I'm going to binge watch him. One, because he's cute. Two, because he's entertaining. And three, because he's talented.
I want him to be watching content. Like, watch as in, like, little, like,
so he can be like us and get demonetized.
Yeah,
like,
Boondocks type content.
So
like,
he can get demonetized.
You're right.
That's exactly what you're
but
saying.
But he is entertaining, and I'll give him
time. That was the best thing y'all ever sent us to react to. That was really entertaining. All right, so next victim.
Oh, my God.
Mila.
Chrissy's bitch.
Okay, now this is the thing, right? People sent me Chrissy and Mila, but they said to react to them separate. But I'm just gonna do Mila because I've never watched anything of Mila's.
Oh boy.
Never clicked on her channel, never nothing. So
I watched one video, paused it, and just read the comments.
First of all, she has 87K.
From being
Chrissy's bitch?
Chrissy's bitch.
After Donald.
Donald out here making people famous.
Bitch. Give me clout. I want 87K too. Well, I got more than that, but the point is, damn. This is like in the span of like a year, isn't it?
Yeah.
Alright, so what we want?
Damn,
you could pick this video.
Donald and Chrissy broke up a year ago.
I feel like it's been a year, yeah.
It didn't feel like a year.
I don't know, but that whole situation was stupid. But that song was good. That song that came out of it, that,
mm-hmm.
that, whatever.
How did it go again?
I don't remember.
I just hate you. She thought that he got goldfish in her mouth.
I'm
snoring
out of my
ear.
Yo, shut up!
Domo, listen. Shout out to Domo. Bye. Domo needs to enunciate her words.
That song was dope. I just don't remember the name of the song right now. Mm-hmm. I don't remember the name of the song, but I know what you're talking about. Just a tag. Fuck, let me go get in a relationship, break up with them. You know?
We're living in a working game. So today we're gonna do the chest.
Honestly, I just want to be able to react to how. I just want to read the comments, to be honest.
Just
look
at what I
mean. I want to see Kristen's reaction if she don't say any slick shit, because this was her. The Chocolate Child was actually a viral video of her and Donald did it. She had like 6 million views.
Really?
6 million.
So she went and did it with her new bitch?
Mm-hmm.
That's grimy.
Y'all subscribe to her channel, subscribe to her Sam channel too, she just created.
Chrissy's so fucking lame. A Sims channel. How old is she? 35?
There's a lot of adults who have those.
Six, wait, no. Seven different flavors. Wow, like obvious one. Like,
let me get a boyfriend.
Mango, strawberry.
Like, somebody who's willing to kiss me on camera. Hoes, text me when you see this. Let me stop. I don't have a hoe. Nobody likes me.
We got strawberry.
Chrissy lost a lot of weight.
Yeah, she did.
We got mango, melon, cherry, strawberry, watermelon.
How is she such a natural and so damn fast? Didn't she just make this damn channel on a year ago?
They can edit themselves out, put it on blindfold. Dear God. They still ate.
I think they did, because now she's putting on the blindfold. She skipped the whole part.
That's how warm they are.
Why is she putting all those peace signs or what the fuck is this? My thing?
I don't know. This is a corn ball.
Oh, Starburst. There's Starburst chapstick?
Yep.
She go buy that.
Oh wow, this is a shoebox now. Double stop playing alimony checks. Damn, I wonder where the kitchen go.
I can't. Why you had to do that? Why you had to do that? Yo, that was grimy. You ain't had to say all that. Alimony, first of all, she wouldn't got to get a kid.
Where's the furniture?
Stop, there is furniture. Look. Wait, what's that?
That one little stove. That one painting on the wall. Where the bedroom's at?
Alright, we're not gonna do this, Trey.
But it's the dining room. She don't have clickbait money that she was using Elon Domo's name for months.
We don't even know whose house is this. Do they live together?
They live together. Oh. Apparently, from what I've heard. I don't know if they live
in. What state they live in?
They live in fucking Indiana, I think.
Maybe it's bigger. Indiana ain't that expensive. Alright.
They're boring.
I don't want to watch them kissing anymore. That was disturbing.
Boring.
As hell. Let's see what the comments say.
The hate just died down.
Yeah, it did. Well, shout out to y'all for not being so hateful towards them after
people just moved
the disaster.
On.
Yeah, it's good that people
but
moved on.
Yeah, y'all are on Chris's dick still. Even though Chrissy cheated just like...
It's supposed to be me, you. Mm-hmm. I don't care if nobody says I love Chris Dale's music.
I can fall in love like that. It's supposed to be me. I can't get it down like that. I still love enough to love you. No offense, Chris. I like Chris. No offense.
Yo! Ex victim is Prince E. Never heard of him. I don't even know if I'm saying it right. I don't know if it's Prince EA or just Prince E, because E and A makes an E sound. Never heard of him. Looks like he makes music as well as YouTube videos, but he has 4.3 million.
Ooh.
Black man, go support. Black. Oh wait, go support everybody.
Yes,
he's black, except for the one 10,000 calorie guy, which I don't support that type of nonsense, but that's good content. If that's what you're into, go subscribe, but yeah. Okay, so I guess I get to pick this one. Every teenager needs to hear this. I got a lot of teenagers on my page, and this is only 3 minutes long. We'll watch that.
People you were hanging out with are not your friends. I want you to ask yourself this question. Are they raising you up or pushing you down? Are they helping you grow or holding you back?
I've seen this man on Facebook. Prince E.
But I feel like the people you hang around, they have their own agendas. And I've had people like this in my life before. People who wanted to get close to me, used me to get what they wanted, and then once they got it, they left. So you can't call everybody your friend. The word friend comes from a European word, friend, meaning to love. These people, they don't love you. They don't belong in your squad. A squad is a team of people who you go to war with. They fight with you. You fight with them. You fight together. See, a true friend isn't somebody who makes your problems disappear, but they are the ones who won't disappear when you face problems. See, fake friends are like shadows. They're around you during the brightest times, but they disappear during the darkest times. So I'm gonna tell you this. It's better to walk alone at night than with a fake friend in the light. Better a enemy than a fake friend hug you. See, I know sometimes it's fun hanging out with them. You laugh, you joke, but see, that don't mean much. It's easy to be friends when things are going well. But what about when things ain't going well? Oprah said, everybody wanna ride with you in a limo. But what about when that limo breaks down and it's cold? Who's gonna be there with you on the side of the road? Who's gonna be there to carry your bags with you as you gotta walk home? See, I don't wanna preach, but your life is dependent on two things: the people you hang out with and the books you read. Do not stunt your growth by hanging out with the wrong crowd. I'm gonna say it again. You have a gift inside of you. You gotta answer that call, because it's not gonna ring forever. The more time you spend with these people, the less time you're gonna have to bring that gift out. I know you may say it don't matter, they don't affect me. And to that, I'm gonna ask you this. What's the easiest way to catch a cold? You hang out with somebody with a cold, right? Well, what's the easiest way to catch a negative mindset? You hang out with somebody with a negative mindset.
Dead ass.
The energy you hang around, it matters. You can't hang around energy vampires. They say people come into your life for a reason, a season, or a lifetime. See, I believe these so-called friends you have,
I like that one.
Their season has passed, and it's your season now, where you flourish, where you grow, and you become exactly who you were always meant to be.
Beautiful. That was beautiful.
Beautiful message.
Beautiful everything. Subscribed. Well, that was good.
Personally, I can't relate because I didn't really have friends growing up. So
I feel like everyone, this is every teenager. This needs to be like everyone, because I still know adults that do stupid shit like hang out with the wrong fucking people.
Matter of fact, you're right. Adults can hear this too. As a teenager, I wouldn't have been able to relate, but as an adult, now you can really relate. Now things get more personal.
Right.
But then I just see you at school. So that was a very good one. So he's good. I'm going to watch his videos for sure. I'm going to check out his videos.
Right. So the next one is the Rush Fam.
That's all we care about, is the original content.
Right, like for real. Like, I need something different. The Rush Fam.
I watch the Rush Fam sometimes. I got bored as fuck with them, so I stopped watching them for a while.
So this is an interracial couple. I already know how y'all feel about
that. Yeah, a Canadian interracial couple.
I love interracial couples. I think they're beautiful, but I'm not into families.
So when I was younger, I used to look up on YouTube interracial families, because I just always thought it was so beautiful. Like, I just love
the family.
Because a lot of people have a problem with interracial relationships. I just love watching them. Have you ever dated a white person before?
No, I always kind of wanted to, but I don't have any like white people in my area. They're all like of Hispanic descent, or they're of Haitian descent. And if they're white, they're like not like fully white. They're like usually mixed. I've only talked to one white boy. He was like Italian, and he was like mixed with a whole bunch of European ancestry. But I think he had a little bit of Hispanic in him. But he was just a little too hood. Like, he was way hood. Like, he was thuggish. He was very cute. He had beautiful eyes, blonde hair. He was pretty. But it just never worked out. He actually hit me up a couple months ago, but I was like, I'm good.
Was he on Instagram?
He hit me up on Facebook. Let me stop talking too much. He probably watches my videos. People, I always get caught up saying stupid shit. So I don't know what to pick here. This is just a whole bunch of shit. I picked the last one, so.
They have a lot of viral videos.
I'm looking at their newest stuff.
They're just watching forever. I haven't watched them in months.
Yeah, let me see.
Probably almost a year I haven't like really been engaged in something. Like, I just don't care. Like,
yeah, I don't care for family channels, but yeah, I decided to pick
them. Like, you grow out of family channels. Especially when they just do the same thing over and over.
But let's do this. She taught me.
They're problematic.
She taught me how to dance. So I guess it's the kids teaching him how to dance.
What's next on the list?
What's poppin', T-Squad?
Oh, he is so cute.
He used to be a model.
Oh, he is cute. Right, so
the whole gang is here, as you guys
can see. Calm down, he's a married man.
This is one of those days, guys, where we do not know what we're going to do. We just got in the car.
Let me stop.
And they're mad young too. She's only 29 and he's 32. They got parents.
So stay tuned to find out.
That's a lot of fucking kids.
What do you guys want to do?
The fuck?
There's more.
What?
Yeah.
There's more than three of them?
Two of them are theirs, one of them is their nephew, and they have a third one that's a newborn. But they have three kids.
That's too many kids, I'm sorry.
Why does this happen every single time
that you're going to
go somewhere?
That's a nice car.
Cars, you just woke up, you were sleeping too.
Bruh, I gotta tell you something about the kids. So the kids have a very successful YouTube channel. Like, if anything, their kids pay their rent more than their own YouTube channel. Their kids have a kid YouTube channel. They were like, you know what? Kids are profiting. They made their kids a YouTube channel, and within 2 months, they gained over 200,000 subscribers.
Doing what?
Slime videos, Dr. Stuffins videos, dressing their kids up. And they get, their most viral video has over 50 million views. See, everybody, you stop pimping out your kids.
Bruh.
That's where all the money is.
I'm about to, I don't even have kids.
where all the money is.
That's insane.
You know what, they wake up at 7:30, even though they went to sleep late, they still wake up early, and then they make the most noise, have the most energy, and then burn it out before
you hear the Canadian accent.
So this always happens, but that's alright, we're gonna wake them up.
He's really cute.
We're gonna show you where we're at. How's your nap, bro?
Weirdo.
I'm a weirdo? You're a weirdo. How's your nap?
Good. Looks like his dad.
Yeah, it really does.
I don't know if it's me, but his kids don't really look like it should be. This is like light skin, black
skin. I don't believe that anyone can look biracial. I don't think there's a biracial word.
I feel like, you know, you're right, but let's say they don't stereotypical.
Yeah, the stereotypical, yeah.
They, to me, they exist as black children, and they probably would be treated as black children.
Yeah, definitely.
They wouldn't be treated as, oh, you can tell they're all very, very white.
That's true.
Callie's a sticky face right now, but she's got on a full Adidas outfit.
You're right, a lot of kids, sometimes it depends on your genotype.
I know so many biracial people that
are she has the strongest genes, but you can definitely tell those kids.
So shout out to Roman Atwood, smile more.
And here's my dad's outfit, and he looks very good today.
Bro, they got the kids vlogging.
Nike socks, Nike shoes.
Sign them young.
And six shorts that I like.
I need my kids to be.
A cool shirt.
So we are in this, like, what is this place even called? It's like a fun world, a play place.
I'm not into vlogs, so I'm not gonna subscribe, but their family is adorable as all hell.
They're problematic, they're unproblematic, they're chill. Nothing really bad to say about them.
Do you got a brother or something?
No, he's not even tired of things.
I can't ever win. What is this? Is this a roller coaster?
Yeah.
I don't know. He is not having it. He looks stressed.
Yeah.
Why did he got him in there by himself? Oh my god.
He's the oldest, to be honest. He's like 8.
Oh my god. 8? What the fuck did he have in his
face? These kids when they were like 20, 23. Yeah.
Okay.
Like, probably like your age, my age. Can you imagine being a parent at your age right now?
Hell fuck no. I can barely handle the cat I'm about to bring home. Alright, they sound cute. I guess the dancing thing is
not
this big. I just
don't find this much entertaining.
Yeah, this is not entertaining.
They're just a cute family, and I think I just like when they do, like...
Yeah, I would skip to the dancing part, but I don't really care.
Yeah.
But, I mean, 1.3 million interracial couple, they're really cute. I'm not gonna subscribe, but
You know what's funny? They gained over 300,000 subscribers in 7 months of doing YouTube. Couple channels are the wave, and they've been doing YouTube for 3 years.
Who wanna be my boyfriend? Send in your applications! Wait? That's nuts. Dang Matt Smith is the last boy. Never heard of this person. 8.9 million subscribers.
Wow.
Black man! Anyways, never heard of him. What are we about to see today? Okay, things we all do secretly. Oh wow, this was posted 4 hours ago. People who are in a very bad situation featuring my girlfriend 1 day ago. Girlfriend? That's clickbait. It has to be clickbait. Photos that need an explanation right now. I don't know what she's watching.
Photos that need an explanation right now.
Okay.
Okay, 3, 2.
He looks familiar.
I know exactly who that is.
What kind of SpongeBob is this?
He's a very famous reaction channel. SpongeBob. Oh, what's his name again?
Dang Matt Smith?
Oh, yeah.
I feel like I've seen him before.
That baby used to be reacting all the time. But he don't do music video reactions because they get popular.
We're taking a look at photos that need an explanation right now. Be sure to click that subscribe button and smash the like button. And comment down below your favorite show. My channel can be your favorite show if you want. You can comment it down below. But yeah. Or your favorite show on TV or Netflix. Just let me know. But if I was sitting up in this class, I would have blown a dart or thrown a pen at this point.
These types of videos do very well. You know how I know these videos do well?
Sniper Wolf.
Yes, as a Sniper Wolf, not only that, back in my days when I was like extremely little, like 5,000, 6,000, I had did a few of these. The fucking monetization, like the CPM on these is, bruh. I think I deleted them because they just didn't relate to my channel anymore.
Blasphemous.
Yeah, and it's just boring. I want to have a higher purpose because it doesn't really do anything. This is just entertaining, but... they do very well, and they killed everyone.
Whoever brought this thing, they should be criminally prosecuted and thrown in jail.
So we need a niche, y'all.
To like bring a creepy SpongeBob balloon like that. Now this right here needs a serious explanation.
If you're good at grilling,
like cannibalism, like the cheetah eating Cheetos.
Yo, no, for real.
This poor cheetah, he's like, what you got there, man? You got some Cheetos. Man, that kind of looks good. But hey, it ain't easy.
This editing?
That joke was cheesier than some Cheetos.
Yeah, I just realized that Taco Bell,
they got like the Doritos Locos Taco. They should have the Cheetos Locos Taco. That would be good.
This is perfect. His background is perfect. He got the subscribe and the like below. This is very good.
These are the people that thrive on YouTube, the black people that do stuff like this.
Yeah.
You gotta be whitewashed to thrive on YouTube.
Say that.
You really do though. You gotta be whitewashed, like sitting up straight, no cussing, like you can't really let loose and let the hood out. They don't want to dip. YouTube don't want Negroes on this platform. They want you to be polished and like this. He is an excellent role model for young children. And people like me who
does his shirt really say family friendly?
People like me who say they want to move to ISIS or North Korea can't.
Even... you need to stop saying that. And ISIS is not a place, stop saying that. It's a terrorist group. Yo, you fucking ignorant. That's why your ass get demonetized.
Right.
Honestly, I have no critiques for this. He's really good. I don't know. You know, I think I'm actually gonna subscribe. I'm a subscriber.
He's talented.
I like that type of content.
Good quality content. Not for me, but people with ADD and young children might like this.
Next one is Nicole TV. Now, Nicole TV.
I like Nicole TV.
Never watched her a day in my life. 1.4 million subscribers,
and
y'all.
She's a dark-skinned
black woman, okay? For those of you who like to say that black people don't get enough shine, there's a lot of them. Y'all sent me a lot of fucking, like, black people that are in the millions, and I'm too happy for them. A lot of them are young too, so that's great. Not all of them, okay, Troyce, are whitewashed, but I feel like a lot of them,
whitewashed.
I feel like a lot of them just appeal to a white audience. I think that's what it is.
Like,
I don't think,
neon,
yeah, they just appeal to a white audience. I don't think they're whitewashed per se.
Because
just,
white people want you to be the stereotype or the polished version.
Okay,
of what they
did you find a video body. Yet?
Oh, okay.
Did you? Because you go to white.
You need a brush.
I've seen this.
Lift this brush.
That's 8 million views, my love.
I've seen this. I'm dead.
That's not Netflix, bro. Ooh.
Bitch, you gonna rip your damn hair out.
Girl.
Is that even safe to do that?
Not like that. Girl.
Now, almost. Nick, what the f? Stop. If you have longer hair, it still should work, but just not with gel, I don't think. Now, gel.
I use black gel too.
But if you can't use gel in your hair, then use gel.
If you are she's right.
Head, you just, oh my god. Just get off the video. Okay. What? Open the gel like this. Put it up on top or around, doesn't matter. Just make sure you put gel on it. Last step. All you really need is a rubber band. Twist the ponytail if you want.
That shit is like half ass. Slick up. You need to cut that shit off.
The gel, then take your rubber band.
Who told you this was okay?
And just cut it.
You don't bluff that shit down the toilet.
And now you're done. Oh my god, you don't have to make the ugly faces like content. And after you finish watching this move, give me a little tutorial. Post a picture of your ponytail in the comment section.
She's funny.
I like her. She's cute.
I'm subscribed to her, but I don't watch her shit that much.
You know, subscribing to someone and not watching them is actually hurting their channel.
Oh, it'll be fine.
God. If you didn't know that, that's a real thing, y'all. If you just subscribe, that's why I try to unsubscribe to people as much as possible from not watching them, because I'm really hurting them in the long run. I don't know what she makes now. Is this all she does? Oh, National Girlfriend Day Surprise, Bella Ate My Clothes. Okay, so she's like a... Last one! Jessica the Prankster. I've never in my life
heard of that
girl, but she knows everybody.
Is she black?
Yes, I think. I think she's biracial. But as I know, I consider my sister black, but she's like, she has videos of people that I've heard of, but I looked at it earlier. 1.9 million subscribers. Okay, baby powder and hair dryer prank on mom. My mom was yelling at people in Walmart day in the light. Long armpit hair prank on mom. See, her mom's white, so I'm assuming she's biracial. Assuming her dad's black. Mumi and Smooth Geo sung Blue Flakes lyrics. Like, she knows these. That's why I'm like, what the fuck? How come I never heard of her? Me and my mom told the Taylor girls we don't like them prank. She knows everybody, but I've never heard of her. Aggravating my mom until she flips, must watch. I think I'll click on that.
I'm watching Stranger Things.
I want to pick a YouTuber for you to react to.
Okay.
For a bonus round.
Watching what? Stranger Things. And ever since he started dating Elm, he pushed
she's very cute.
Away,
she is really pretty.
And stuff like that, because he got a girlfriend, he don't know how to act. So...
And what's this got to do with me?
I'm just saying.
I don't care. I don't Stranger Things. I don't care about Stranger Things.
I don't care about you. So when I get a boyfriend, I'm going to push you away.
What if I could just push you away right now? I wouldn't give a damn.
Why am I going to come out like that?
You better stop now. I'm already frustrated and goddamn aggravated now.
You make your own self frustrated.
I got to wait for these people to give me my medicine and shit. It's been like 2 hours.
My mom told me
15 minutes I should get the shit out of you. She told a damn lie.
You always talking about your own stuff. Okay. One day. Listen, one day you're going to try the wrong person.
One day, which is, it won't be you. It won't
don't
be you.
Don't do that.
I ain't studying nobody.
Don't do
just
it.
Just get your hand in my face. I'm in a lot of goddamn pain.
You put your hand in my face and then you can't be like, oh, because I'm grown. It don't matter if you're grown. If somebody put...
This is entertaining as fuck.
You got your feet all up in my... I'm like, in my...
Why is she always looking at me?
Oh, hey! You better shut up. Look at you, you always flinching. I'm scared.
No, because I was going to do that.
No, you want me to punch me? Girl, I'll be going to bring the brakes off your ass.
Yo, what the fuck? Come on, me old channel. Fuck that.
Dang, you always find somebody else to mess with. Dang. Ooh. Why are you touching me? Stop touching.
Oh, I'm
not doing it to you.
Bro.
Ah, my head hurts. Get your lip. Girl, get your hands off my head. I saw you scratching your ass a minute ago. Now you want to put your hands...
What are you doing with it?
You be farting in your sleep, so don't try me. And then you want to...
I don't think I'll subscribe because it's not my type of content that I would watch on a regular basis. Maybe I'll have to think about it. But I actually like her. I really do. I think she's very cute as well. Videos long as shit. And y'all wanted this video to be long as fuck, so I don't want to hear no complaints about how long this video is.
Yeah.
All right. Woo! Miss on me?
That's it?
Yep, that's it. We did 11. Oh, wait, you said you had an extra person?
Yeah, for the bonus round, I'm going to pick an extra person for us to react.
All right, wait. So, since y'all want this video to be long, and I know y'all still gonna complain, Troy's got a bonus round person. Last time you had me react to that Peaches bitch, that was not funny.
Oh,
I was traumatized. So it better not be no more Peaches nonsense. I don't wanna hear nothing about people eating doo-doo in the toilet or whatever the hell you talk about. That girl nuts. I don't want name. I'm afraid to see what you get me to react to. Oh my God, Lord. Please don't be no nonsense. I probably already know who it is. I feel like you want some dumb shit, yo. You about to give me some
I'm
shit.
I'm still looking.
Okay, good. That means the person probably don't got a channel or something.
It's your boy Travis Chicken E.
Team K Squad.
And it is your girl Kiana, aka Queen Key of in this thing.
Hello, haters. Hello, subs. Hello, viewers that don't sub. Hello, everyone. We are here.
What is going on with me?
Just say hello to everyone. Hello, hang-ass other YouTubers.
They're entertaining, you can't deny that.
Honestly, you know what, this needs to be said. I've been meaning to say this, but I don't say it.
Hold on, let's finish it. Oh, a couple seconds.
Eternity later.
G14K, all they do is make video about Queen.
That is all y'all do.
They make a video about us every fucking day. A lot of people though. Yes, it's a lot of people.
Like, these,
but how do you know that it's not searching?
I thought they were
irrelevant. The audience, like, even when it happened to Ja Rule, the people didn't get into it, was too late. After you captured him, they just said they killed him. Then people are like, hold up. He doing the same shit. You know what I'm saying? People don't realize it, but now people are starting to realize it, but you just got people that hate TNK. So they like, yeah, more TNK. But it's like,
I always say those be the TNK region.
Do with a block, they come over there? Exactly. But
people want to be like them so badly.
I can't take this anymore. First of all, if this wasn't my phone, I'd probably slap it across the fucking room. This is the thing. They irritate my soul.
What is so bad about them doing it?
They didn't do anything to me. But the thing is, these people are way too old to be talking about children the way they do. Not even children, but young adults. The way they do, like, how old are they? Like, senior citizens?
They're only 43 or 46.
Only, bitch? At 43 or 46, y'all nah, like, past 30, there's some of y'all lying about your age out there. Past 30, but yet, you shouldn't be out here making drama videos. At that point, you just look a little pathetic. That is just my personal
opinion.
Old people
can't be on YouTube?
I'm saying, if you're gonna be old and on YouTube, give something enriching, like, how to do your taxes, how to buy a house, how to increase your credit score, advice on life, fake friends, you know, stuff like that. Not, oh, I think Queen a bad parent.
Wendy Williams does it.
That's different. At least she's on real primetime TV making money from it. I don't like Wendy Williams either, but at least I respect her grind and she's actually doing shit. These people are making pennies off of talking about kids. Like, essentially to them, kids. They can be these niggas' parents. Like, cool, let's be real here. Like, they could be these kids' parents. Like, you really sitting here reacting to pranks. Yo, that's a little pathetic, y'all. Like, I'm sorry, it just is. And I know this probably won't get back to you. Why we was doing so good. We was doing so good, Trace. You just irritated me by putting these motherfuckers in my damn face. This was the worst thing I've ever reacted to all damn day.
What are you gonna give them?
A negative 52. I can't do it.
I'm not gonna lie. They're entertaining. I don't know if you're watching.
There is nothing entertaining about these people. I have no idea. Yo, this is some shit, bruh. Don't hate them, but I feel like they really need to find something better to do. Like, do something for the culture. Like, do something for, like,
and what happened to the replied say, well, bitch, all you have to do is rant about racist people.
That's doing something. I'm bringing awareness to social issues that black people and people of color go through. Okay, I'm bringing awareness to bad parents. Clearly, they should be in the series. Because, like, what is this? This is not something that I just can't. This is a little embarrassing. That's just my personal opinion. You all gotta agree. For the TNK fans out there, it is what it is. I can't. Keep doing your shit, whatever. If they do so happen to respond to this, just know you're not getting a response back because I have black kids to uplift on this channel. This It's just for entertainment purposes. This is just for fun. I have black kids to uplift. I have black queens to mold. And black kings to, shit, try to save me and kill my cup. I ain't got time for that type of shenanigans. I am above the YouTube drama. That was like back in the day. I didn't even know people still make like drama videos like that. Like, I thought that genre was dead, but I mean, it's old to do. Didn't they try to get deleted? Like,
yeah, but they're back.
Bro, they already got like 8,000 on their new channel.
That's crazy.
That's okay. Really good. So shout out to y'all for that. That's good that y'all, you know, they getting back. Like, I'm not trying to say don't do YouTube, but I'm saying like try to do something more productive and more like something. Like, this is not productive. This is embarrassing. But that's just my personal opinion.
Okay. Everyone talks to their own opinion.
Exactly.
I think that's it. Exactly. This video.
That's it. No more trash. My head hurts. Let me know what you think about who we react to down in the comment section below. Let us know who you watch, who you didn't watch, who you're going to subscribe to, who you're already subscribed to, whatever the case may be. And when we make another one of these in the next couple months and probably get dragged, because I know some people are going to probably catch offense to some of the shit that we said. Oh, well.
It is what it is.
Right. Like, we said what we said. I said what I said. I meant what I said. And I'll say it again. Get your merch in the motherfucking shop. All right. Make sure you like, share, subscribe, follow Troyce on YouTube if you haven't already. Follow him on Instagram. Everything you need is going to be down in the description and in the pinned comment down below. If you mad, stay mad. If you not, subscribe. Bye, y'all!